Hi, welcome to World T'ai Chi Day. I'm Guy Furness, president of the Rochester T'ai Chi Quan Center, and we're really happy to have all of you folks here, and we're really happy to run this for every year. But I really have to introduce a gentleman who has been trying to get this to work, and maybe a slow learner, but he's only been doing this for 19 years. It's starting to come together. So here's Brian.
Welcome to the 21st World T'ai Chi and QiGong Day celebration. Hosted by the Rochester T'ai Chi Chuan Center, this is the 19th local participation in this annual worldwide event. I'm Brian Bruning, coordinator of this event, and I'd like to thank the Brighton School District for the use of their facilities, and to the teachers and their students who are here today. Thank you all for coming to witness participate in this global health and healing event. Today we join T'ai Chi and QiGong practitioners around the world in public exhibitions of ancient techniques to promote and celebrate a healthier world. Given that over 70% of illnesses sending patients to the doctor are rooted in unmanaged stress, T'ai Chi and QiGong has the potential benefit of improving many lives and reducing healthcare costs worldwide. T'ai Chi and QiGong focus on precise execution of postures and breathing to improve balance, leg strength, flexibility, fine motor control, and more. This fosters a calm and tranquil mind, which helps to reduce stress and increase circulation of qi or vital energy. Both T'ai Chi and QiGong balance outward energy expanding activities with quiet energy accumulating practices. To quote Professor Da Liu, to perform the T'ai Chi exercise correctly, one must be very peaceful and quiet inside while executing the externally visible movements. And now I'd like to introduce Brighton Supervisor William Moehle.
Thank you so much, Brian. I'm dressed a little more casually than you often see me. We've had a great day already of activities, especially for our kids. We're doing tree planting this morning to celebrate Arbor Day. We have kids catch and release fishing derby this morning, and kids are beautiful. They have no clue that there's stuff, white flaky stuff falling from the sky. They're just out doing it, and it's just exciting. But so is this. It really is humbling every year to welcome the T'ai Chi and QiGong practitioners here to Brighton to know and to understand that you and we are part of a worldwide effort, and that worldwide effort is focused on health, mental health, physical health, the communal gathering of people towards this one end. Is truly something marvelous. So again, I want to welcome you all to Brighton, thank the school district for having you here, and wish you all the very best on a good day, World T'ai Chi and QiGong Day. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So Tai Chi should not be hard. It is only about moving different body parts in different directions at different speeds, all arriving at the proper place at the same time. Demonstration you are watching, I'll show you how this comes about. Master Prentice and members of the center will demonstrate this form, which was given to us by Master Kaihong when the Tai Chi Center was formed. Four direction form is a teaching form, helping beginners and advanced players to understand the Tai Chi principles and internal methods of Tai Chi Chuan. The form begins with an understanding of weight transference, and we see the players moving right to left as they demonstrate the principle of weight transference. Tai Chi Chuan begins with upper and lower coordinate. In the commencement movement, the arms and body are moving in different directions. Then they move in the same direction at different speeds. The third movement demonstrates the difference between shifting and turning. One turns to the east and we begin the eight postures of Tai Chi. Downward pull, ward off, roll back, elbow, shoulder strike, split, and push. Single whip. Players turn to the west, single whip posture, and then turn to the north with the reverse fountain posture. They now perform the same nine movements. Downward pull, ward off, roll back, high, press, elbow, shoulder, split, and push. Same posture will be performed in all four directions before returning to the starting point. Additionally, there are five attitudes or steps. Advance, retreat, look to the left, gaze right, central equilibrium. All of these are within the four direction form. When we put them together, the five attitudes and eight postures, we have the 13 classic postures of Tai Chi. Whoever practices Tai Chi correctly and regularly will gain the pliability of a child, strength of a lumberjack, and the peace of mind of a sage. Open hand Tai Chi is a solo form that teaches body mechanics and movement to improve one's balance, health, and well-being. After learning the solo form, some students study other forms such as weapons, fan, stick, staff. The Tai Chi sword of Jian that you will see today is a double-edged straight sword used during the last 2,500 years in China. Tai Chi sword is viewed as an extension of the body. Preserving empty hand Tai Chi principles, the sword tip is pushed and followed with the ultimate goal of moving the body and sword as one. You will now see Grandmaster William C.C. Chen's 64 movement form. This is based on his teacher, Professor Chen Mancheng's form. Thank you.
practice postures, which comes from a Buddhist lineage. A lot of T'ai Chi and QiGong come from Taoist philosophy. This one is also Buddhist. It comes from Mount Sung. And we are going to gather, however you imagine, the healing energies of the universe are, by starting to feel your own presence between your palms, in front of your lower mandible. And as you send your mind out, you are gathering that healing energy and drawing it into yourself, landing in prayer hands, which rest on your sternum. Now the next 7, or 9, or 5, or however slow you're able to make your breathing, that number of breaths are bringing in more and more of this healing energy and releasing anything you don't need. Whenever you endeavor to release energy that's toxic to you, send it with an intention that it's being transformed into something that isn't harmful for wherever you're releasing it. And your breathing is inhaling and inflating the lower abdomen, exhaling and drawing everything back toward the center. This could be thought of as a meditating Buddha. You have now gathered the healing energy of the universe. And as the palms part, they float down to the diagonals, palms forward. And now you can feel connected. Each finger is connected to silver threads that are handling these up to the sky. When you're at shoulders level, they turn out to the diagonals, and you get very tall. Your feet are going beyond the center of the earth. Your head is going out to the stars and the planets. You have really long hair. And each pair is absorbing qi. Also, your skin is absorbing qi. And there's so much space between every cell and fiber that anything that's gummed up in there is blown away by the cosmic winds or the cosmic being. Breathing again in this really slow and nourishing fashion. Using your core to hold the arms up rather than the arm muscles. And any of these that you repeat on your own, you be the authority of what feels good to your body. If this hurts or you're getting fatigued, let it float down then. And when your hands come next to the thighs, you are going to circle the back palm, the back of the Lao Gong Pong, is going to be resting on Ming Men. Ming Men is across from your belly button. So one hand is going to the back, and the other one is coming over the head, reaching up for the yang energy of the sky, then merging with the Baihui point, which is the thing that moves the energy up and down in your body, the qi. Now, as you sweep down, your intent is cleansing out whatever isn't needed all the way down to the level of the bone marrow. You're going to intend it all the way down to the bottoms of your feet. You don't have to bow. You can just sweep with the intent and then use the other hand the same way. as well as imagining, that there is the deepest cleansing, that anything unneeded or toxic is being released. And you can do this in sets of 3, 5, or 9 times. Just do three on each side for this practice. And I love the concept that some people will immediately say, oh, I really get sensation that I recognize from this. And other people will say, what? So the teacher always says, it's okay just to imagine it. It's a place to start in your practice, to imagine that you are bringing this level of healing to yourself. And therefore, to everyone that you interact with. Embody the posture called Nine Demons Draw the Sword. Are we sure we want to do this?
Yeah.
Nine Demons apparently was a warrior. And Nine Demons apparently had his sword case on his back. So you are going to be pointing your fingers up as far as is comfortable. If you just had rotator cuff surgery, you don't want to be pointing your fingers up. And you'll notice I can point them better on one side than on the other. Do what works for you. If you can only get them here, that's completely fine. So the sweep is, the back of the palm is on the hand, and the other hand is going to your ear lobe on the opposite side. Then you are going to turn only from the waist, not the whole torso, the waist, and exhale toward the lower elbow. Turning back with an inhale, the arms circle in the other direction. Your finger goes to the earlobe. Turn from the waist. I love it. From my perspective, you all look so darn cute. I hope that this has a palliative effect. Once, because as the palms float down, you are being filled to your very core of your being with fresh qi. Hoping you feel renewed and restored. And thank you for participating in this.